Ah, Zelda month. The best thing about November, honestly, second only maybe to turkey. And stuffing. Today we'll be taking a look at a very special list. A list of the top 10 Zelda dancers. Now at first glance, Zelda might not seem like the kind of franchise that has a whole lot of dancing going on, but if you pay close attention, you might be surprised. Even Link himself does a little dance on occasion. Because no one can escape the lure of dance forever. Myself included. Yeah, sorry about that. Not really. Silly as it may seem, they do say that Zelda is a universal language, and apparently so is dance. So I figured I'd combine the two, and these are my picks. Enjoy. Let's start this list off right with a group of enthused dance maniacs. Literally everyone in the Melo Mart. What happens to these fine citizens as soon as they enter the doors to this legendary mart is they come down with a serious case of dance fever. But why? I'll tell you why. The prices are just too good. Like just, bargains. I mean, right? But seriously, let's just think about this for a hot moment. Can you imagine if every time you walked into a Walmart, it was full of people singing, "Buy one, get one, I'll take one, I don't really want one, but I'll take one, by gosh, sell it to me." And dancing with a baby capitalist in the corner laughing silently to himself at the fools who fell right into the trap that is consumerism? I'm a baby. It'd be totally weird. Although, now that I think about it, probably still preferable to what you'd normally find in a Walmart.
Oh, you nasty.
You nasty.
Be honest with me. How many other 10-year-olds picked up the Oracle of Seasons for the first time, saw Din, and thought to themselves,
"Oh man, she's hot."
What? No one? Oh, okay. But you have to admit, when you first saw her, your first thought was probably, she's a dancer. But no, she's not a dancer. Not according to this lady anyway, who's apparently Impa, I mean, yep. Yeah, nuts to her. I'm saying she's a dancer. I mean, just look at those moves. Spin, spin, spin and stop, and spin, spin, spin and stop, yeah. She doesn't do anything else. However, she also appears in one of my personal favorite Zelda games, the Minish Cap, where she and her sisters are trying to find a new house to rent. Goddess problems, am I right? The catch is, only one can rent the room. And clearly she didn't win. I'm betting Ferrore did. Cause I mean, the hair? That's some scary business. And yet Din remains true to form. See, even when she's locked to a giant boulder, she's still dancing. Dance to the beat. Dance to the beat. Rock and roll.
Get it, cause the rock.
The Wind Waker is full of strange characters with no real explanation as to why they're so strange. Take for example this guy here. His name's Candy, and he's apparently 17 years old. What kind of candy jar has this guy been taking cookies from? No, but seriously, it's like Mama slipped one too many growth supplements into Candy's drink there and, well, side effects may include hair loss. But we're not here to discuss this man's questionable size for his age, or even this bunny girl wanting to pursue a romantic relationship with one of these guys, or even this. We're here to discuss the greatest dancer in all of Windfall, save for maybe one other.
But that's a secret, shh, just don't think about it.
And his name is...
Tot.
Tot.
Thank you very much.
Tot. His name is Tot, like Tater Tot. Don't ask questions. Tot, while impressively dedicated to his craft of doing the same dance move over and over and never stopping for anything, not bathroom breaks, not food breaks, not sleep, not living an emotionally stable existence, is a bit of a tryhard and therefore unworthy of placing higher in this list. So says I. He also never accomplishes his goal of turning day into night or vice versa, making him a loser. And look at that stupid band-aid. Who even does that?
Thank you.
Game time.
The one redeeming thing about him, however, is his official German name, T. Travolta, as in John Travolta, the actor slash dancer.
You don't make me laugh. Ha ha ha.
Now, I was struggling to decide between this David Bowie and this David Bowie, because we can't have two subservient villains make the list. I mean, it's ridiculous. And while I have to respect this crazy belly dancer backward dance thing, David Bowie's not really a dancer, is he? But David Bowie, on the other hand, most definitely is. I'm not quite sure what's going on here, but it's certainly a dance. Wait, he's summoning someone? David Bowie, you better not be resurrecting Freddie Mercury, or I don't know what I'll do. Up next, we have perhaps the most enthusiastic... Darunia. Trying to shoot a video here. Could you just, like, maybe just take a knee for a sec? Okay, no, but seriously. Darunia, you need to calm down. Darunia, I'm not kidding. You know what happened last- He's the man, the myth, the legend. Well, according to him anyway. He says he's all that in a bag of Kentucky Fried Cuckoo, but I've never even heard of this guy. Kamaro is a mysterious dead dude who somehow bit the dust before he was able to spread his teachings far and wide. And if there's any real tragedy in this world, it's not becoming famous before you die. Truly a sad and pitiful existence. And so he haunts this mushroom rock, patiently waiting for a foolish young lad curious and impressionable enough to risk walking up to a strange dancing man in his underwear. Now, I'm a smart boy and not curious about anything. But seeing as how there's no one else around, I figure I'll bite the bullet this one time. Hey buddy, what's up? And so the land of Termina fell to the evil dancing powers of the self-proclaimed legendary Kamaro, forced to dance the night away until the end of their days. So basically, like, two more days. And then, well, you know. Fee? Is it Fee? Fi? Fo-fum? Jack and the Beanstalk joke is truly something special. She is a gifted dancer. Huh? Oh, thanks, Fi. Anyway, as I was saying, Fi, the goddess sword incarnate, knows how to shake her. Oh, no, that's terrible. Anyway, okay, so, on a scale of what? What is it this time, Fi? What? Yep, no, we're done here. Yeah. Oh, Jesus! This is it. Amongst all the many various dance machines in the Legend of Zelda franchise, only one can rise above the rest and assume their rightful place on the throne. And that character, having beaten out the likes of local legend Kamaro, David Bowie, and all the people from the Melo Mart, is none other than... Now, Tingle is a man of many professions. He's a hot air balloon pilot, he's a cosplayer, he's a map maker, he's even a possible murderer slash slave driver. Actually, he's definitely a slave driver. Maybe murderer. Yep, probably murderer. And with such a colorful repertoire of careers under his belt, one has to ask, just what ties that all in together? The answer is simple. He dances. More specifically, he does one dance, but it's a dance that's iconic and has evolved into something even greater than before with each new game he's in. Take Majora's Mask, for example. He started out a little shy, a little nervous. See? He's got a... See him there? Working up his feet, tapping his toes to the rhythm of his innermost soul dancer, just waiting to unleash the primal dance of fairy passion that he so strongly feels. Do it, Tingle. Do it! He didn't do it. But in the next game, The Wind Waker, Tingle has finally started taking dancing a whole lot more seriously. Probably on account of him having tons of free time being locked up after, you know, the murders and the theft. And the result is simply astonishing. Tingle is the greatest dancer in all of the land of Hyrule. And when he'll dance, he'll not only dance, but he'll totally dance for you and me and Link and Zelda and this guy and this big two, and I don't know what else to sing about, and I need to end this video somehow, and the music is still going, and this is really getting Hoi, one and all. Thanks for watching. I appreciate it. If you'd like to know whenever I get a new video out, feel free to subscribe. And hey, if you liked this video, why not hit like? You can also follow me on Twitter and like me on Facebook if you feel so inclined. And feel free to leave a comment about who your favorite Zelda dancer is. I guess you could say, your favorite Zelda dancer. And before I end this video, I'd like to thank Peanut Butter Gamer for starting Zelda Month. It's a lot of fun, and I'm gonna go play some more Zelda now, and yeah, happy Zelda Month. Marie, I'll need to see you.